I probably had a very idealized view of what college should be. Thought, oh, I'll take a little psychology, I'll take some philosophy and this and that. But of course, we all have to declare a major eventually. And when that time came, I really didn't hesitate to declare a marine science emphasis in biology at Berkeley. And that was great. You know, I felt very comfortable doing that. I spent summers at marine labs like Bodega Bay in Northern California or Friday Harbor Marine Lab up in Puget Sound. And after I graduated, I was determined to get a job in biology because I knew there weren't many jobs like that, and I really wanted to work in the field I'd studied. So I think I applied for like 30 jobs my senior year, and I only got offered one of them, and it was for the California Department of Fish and Game, basically going along the east side of the Sierra Nevada Mountains, electroshocking fish. We'd go into these streams with these huge backpack electroshockers, and we'd just, you know, zap these fish, and they'd float up, and you'd catch them and count them and weigh them, and then turn them loose again. So that was, you know, I did this field work for about 4 months, but really by the end of that, I was realizing that I probably didn't want to continue biology as a career, not only because I saw how demanding physically it could be in the field, but also the kind of biologist I wanted to be no longer existed. I wanted to be a biologist like you might have had 50, 60 years ago, where you could just go out and look at anything you wanted. And there wasn't this huge pressure to publish or to specialize. And I knew I really didn't want to specialize in just one thing the rest of my life. So it was really while I was working for Cal Fish and Game that I just decided one day, oh, I'll be a writer. And I had no idea what I wanted to write at first. I tried some short stories. I took a screenwriting class and wrote a really bad screenplay. I wrote an adult novel that was equally awful. But I also really knew I needed a way to support myself, too. And my stepfather, one of the best things he ever did for me was suggest this master's in scientific instrumentation program at UC Santa Barbara. And the great thing about this program is they actually trained you to do something practical. And so basically, they taught you how to take individual computer components and build instruments with it. Well, I knew I didn't want to do that. I didn't have any aptitude for it. But I learned enough to get good at troubleshooting computers, and I learned how to program computers. And I was lucky enough to get a job after that as a computer consultant for a biologist at UC Santa Barbara. And this was a perfect situation for me because now I could continue to hang in there with biologists and learn about their work, but I also could make enough money to write. And in fact, whenever I got a raise at work, I would cut my hours so I could write more. Fortunately, I had a boss who knew what I was up to and wasn't really opposed to that. But it also gave me a wealth of contacts and material for writing. And after a couple of years, I thought, huh, maybe I should try writing some science for young people. So I wrote this little science article about this deep sea shrimp called Gnathothausia, and I sent it into Highlights for Children magazine. Got a very nice letter back saying, telling me all the things that were wrong with it, but they would like to see it again if I could improve it. So I revised it and I sent it in to them again. And 3 months later, they rejected it again. Well, it took me about 2 years to sell that one little science article, but that was really the beginning of my whole science writing career.